What's up, my riders? What's up? What's up? Hope y'all seen the intro. Good to see y'all again. It's been a minute. Been hella busy, man. And good to see y'all, man, for real. And you see the thumbnail and title, we're talking about that new LFA electric vehicle. Now, I don't know too much about it. We got to read about it. Hope y'all day been going good. Hope y'all week been going good. It's been interesting for me as usual. I've been busy. Excuse me for eating on the vlog, on the live, but a little hungry. I'll be right back. So I just got done working out. I'll be right back. Yeah, like I said, man, we're talking about that new prototype LFA, man. As you know, the LFA came out a few years ago, had one of the baddest sounding exhausts. They actually tuned the LFA exhaust with an actual symphony. They actually did violins and the symphony sound and tuned it to that. So it's really dope. I think they tuned it with Yamaha technology. So that has one of the best sounding exhaust setups still to this day. Don't get me wrong, Mopar is dope and all that, but you know, Mustang, Lamborghini, but LFA with that 3-point, you know, the exhaust had that 3-point setup, that pyramid setup, nasty. But now they got a supercar that's all electric. Now they're talking about having a manual transmission with this vehicle. Let me munch on this a little bit more, then I'm gonna show y'all what I'm talking about. 0 to 100 in two seconds, 2.1 seconds. That's 1, 2, and 100. A car that fast, you got to sit your head back. That'll literally probably give you neck damage. 0 to 100 miles per hour in 2 seconds, man. The car, what they doing with these cars is crazy. Don't ask me why they need to do that, but that's what they wanted to do. You know, Japanese, man, they lead technology forward, man. So we're talking about the LFA. Let's read about it. Future LFA. Lexus future electric LFA supercar. What you need to know.
This is the front part of it. See how they got the hood scoops on it? Look at it. It's nasty. By the way, the original LFA is going for $1 million. If you got $1 million laying around, you can get one. You probably get one for $900,000 if you get a deal. But this is the new electric version. They're thinking about going with this prototype. Look at the, this is nasty. I like everything about it. Look at the hood scoops. Let me get my finger out the way for y'all to see the car. You know my channel still ratchet as I build it, but look, y'all get it. That's a bad mother. Ooh, shut your mouth. That's just the front part, but I'm gonna show you another pics. They got other pics. Back in the 2010s, as I read the bloggers, you know I hate the car bloggers, but I'm gonna read this one because I don't know too much about it, so I gotta read this shit. So this guy says, back in the early 2010s, Lexus, what I just said, produced an epic halo sports car called the LFA. It was expensive for Lexus, with the starting price more than in line with the Ferrari. The brand only built 500 of them, which is true. He's right about that. Some people say 505 because a couple of rich people had the first prototypes of them. But 500 recorded or made total. They were all handmade, by the way, too. All handmade in Japan. Packing a naturally aspirated 4.8 liter V10, the LFA is widely regarded as one of the best sounding, I just said that, road cars ever built. Just said that. These days, prime used examples can fetch more than $1 million in today's market. Just said that too. Didn't I say a million? Well, it just so happens that after years of rumors hitting, that is a return, I'm reading it by the blogger, LFA is getting a revival. Albeit in slightly unexpected form as an electric car during Toyota's EV plans. Presentation, Lexus noted they are building a new battery electric sports car with the driving taste and secret sauce of the LFA. No worry yet about the noise and how the exhaust will sound. So what they're trying to do now with the electric car, they're trying to program the speakers and the sound of the system to mimic actual fossil fuel exhaust sound output. So they're trying to figure that technology out with the LFA, how it's going to sound. They actually have that technology. They're not sending it out all the way in wide form, but there are a lot of companies are working on that. No worry yet about the noise, but they're doing great things with speakers these days, blah, blah, blah. Here's what we know. We should see a version of the electric LFA in 2022. Now, here we go right here. Now, this is a better version. Look at this motherfucker. Let me show y'all something. That motherfucker nasty. Now you can't tell me that bitch ain't nasty. There you go, guys. That's a good shot. Look at the front. Look at it. Would y'all roll in that? Give me a comment. Would y'all buy that? If y'all had the bag, or if you do got the bag, would you buy it instead of a Lambo or a Rari? I think I have to get my Rari still, but I would get that too. That's an exotic electric car. I would have to get that. Now I'm pretty sure they only gonna make so many units of this. That motherfucker nasty. New, fresh, nobody has it. A production electric version of LFA could take a while. Lexus won't debut its first EV, the RZ, until the middle of 2022. There have been rumors of from Japan about Lexus launching a new LFA in 2025. But those same rumors have the LFA packing twin turbo 4.0 V8 with the plug-in hybrid. Some estimates have suggested the final version may not hit the streets until 2030. They said we may get a better peek in what the LFA will look like than the early concept seen here much earlier than that. A report from British publication Autocar claims that Lexus will show a version that's closer to production at the 2022 Goodwood Festival of Speed in June. The future Lexus LFA should be insanely quick. Lexus noted the new electric supercar will have a low two second 0 to 60 miles per hour time. They said 0 to 100 in 2 seconds. So 0 to 60 in 2 seconds. So 0 to 100 probably 4 seconds to be in reality. We also said that the target range is 435 miles, which is dope. This is a supercar and got a range of 435 miles. Now, if you open this bitch up, you're not gonna get 435 miles, guys. You know what I mean? Let's be realistic. If you get this car and open it up, you hauling ass somewhere down from, like, I live in the Midwest. So you just say, for example, we got this bitch and you want to see what it do, but you're going to take it down to Florida. You're going to head to the East Coast, Southeast Coast to Florida. And you open it up, because once you get to Tennessee, you can start opening up your shit, right? Once you get out of the Midwest, the state troopers are a little bit less. Still got to be careful coming through Chattanooga before you hit Atlanta and then hit Florida. But if you take that route, you can open it up. But 435 miles, you're not going to get because this bitch is fast. So you're probably going to get half of that. So keep that in mind. Although, to be fair, that number may be less, see, using the rougher EPA standards rather than those used in Japan. Let me see. Lexus has said the new sports car may use solid-state battery technology. Toyota is reportedly working on those solid-state batteries as we speak, which would be safer, more durable, and more energy-dense than current EV batteries. And it can take heat more, from what they say, and it can take the cold more. The crazy storms we get now in the world. The major benefits of solid-state batteries, you can get more range, of course, out of the same size battery pack. So manufacturers can either add range to current EVs or keep the same range, but reduce vehicle weight considerably. Say that three times. The other key benefit is charging. A solid state battery will be able to charge much more quickly than a conventional battery, which is true. If such technology is expensive to start, a halo car like the new electric LFA could be a sensible place to implement it first. That said, Toyota also could go another way. While the brand has pledged to get their first solid-state battery on the road by 2025, maybe 2024, the Japanese don't fucking play. They be moving. Reports suggest that's likely to be in hybrid rather than pure electric car. Lexus may give the new LFA a manual transmission. Oh, that'd be sick. Here's the old one from back in the day. Back in the day, move right there. Look at that exhaust. Can't see. That's the double one. It's one with the triad too. The titanium has the triad, but that's one with the double. I think that's a new setup, but it has the triad one. LFA president Koji Sato told Top Gear that Lexus was experimenting with putting a simulated manual transmission in an LFA to simulate driver engagement. That's the speakers I was telling you about. So when you turn on your speakers, you got a setting in there where you got your regular radio, you got your Apple CarPlay, you can bump your sound, but then you turn it over to a stern setting and your car sound of your revs and all that would sound like you actually got a fossil fuel engine downshifting and all that. It's dope technology, man. So you will get that same experience. They're trying to home it in now, like you actually in a fossil fuel car. Damn near like you forget you in an EV. It's a hobby of mine, a crazy thing, Sato told Top Gear. I'm looking for better engagement. See, they want it to be a driver's car is what Sato is saying. I'm looking for better engagement. Even in an EV, I want another link from the car to the driver. I just said that, see? It's not just about efficiency. I love cars and want something different. That's what Sato, my man Sato. Okay, which is president of Lexus, Koji Sato. Lexus developing an EV manual transmission will explain why Toyota has 8 patents related to one. Man, they spent some bread. Let's see if we can pull some up videos. Put up a video. I got a video for y'all. Wait. So. The Supercar Blondie. Y'all check her out. She's dope. This chick was going everywhere, you having all the dope shit. I'm trying to like this.
Look how the back spins. Ah, this is awesome. Am I knocking anything down? No? Okay.
Y'all watch this video. Y'all ain't seen it. Y'all watching it now.
Now reverse. Oh, I did it! All right. Yay! I didn't wreck the car. Oh, that's fantastic. fantastic. Good news. Let's see what is inside this box. Are you ready? Alright, one of the most popular supercars ever is back. Here it is, underneath this car cover. Now come around here, it says, Lexus Zuzu. It actually says, Lexus Sport car cover. So here we go, alright, are you guys ready? Let's do it.
Nasty. Has the center caps on it. Quick release center caps like a race car. Look at this thing.
Look at this. Bam! Nasty. There we are.
I'm a fucking nasty. CJ on 32s. You ain't got this one. You ain't got this in your collection, CJ. You ain't got this bad boy.
This right here is the LFA successor,
nasty.
The LFB, because, you know.
Shout out to CJ on 32. Congratulations on that race, too. You just bought that new Ghost Black bag. Shout out to that guy.
This right here is so special. It does not even have a name yet. It's just been brought in from Japan.
Brand new, guys.
Of Lexus. Right. You may already go, oh, yeah. Oh, my God. Looks so cool. Take me around all the features. Don't worry, it's coming right now. There are a few design features that you will recognize from the LFA. Here, it kind of goes up like this, straight down and across, and you've got this triangle form, just like in the LFA, right, in the headlights. That's but of course, it's fully like updated and modern.
I still like
there are so many little design features that you can recognize from the LFA, but they've kind of like gone, let's make it super futuristic. At the same time, we need to kind of nod to how cool the original LFA looked, right? So you'll remember on the hood, there were like two little air vents here. Now, instead of having two up here, they've got two air outlets. The LFA I got to drive in Sydney years ago.
That's the three.
Absolutely nice. Loved it. It's one of the best sounding cars, in my opinion, in the world.
I agree. Look at that. That's the triangle one.
Now,
exhaust.
This is going to be
that's
fully electric. So,
I was telling y'all about.
What are they going to do with the sound?
Nice.
I really hope that that's something that they're working on because, of course, electric cars in the future, they can sound however we want them to sound. So I really hope they take that kind of like LFA scream and somehow work it into how this car sounds in future. You've got these 20-inch wheels here in the front and you've got 21 in the back, so it kind of leans forward, right? And then you've got the center lock wheels. Now this is for racing. It's like what you see the car comes into the pit lane.
That's just crazy, bro.
So it comes off really, really quickly. That's so cool. And then down here, you'll see this is kind of a sloping back. This is very different from the original LFA. The original LFA was kind of like had a high back and it kind of went straight down, but this is more sloping. The design of this car needs to be a little bit different to the LFA.
Man, because of course this
is fully electric. So a lot of it needs to be designed around the aerodynamics, like how far
this
car can actually go in one charge.
That is some type of shit I would have in my garage,
which is, they say, going to be about 700 kilometers. The technology they put into this car is going to dictate the future of all Lexus cars.
Yes.
So the tech that they put in this, we're going to see in the whole lineup going forward. So they're like, right, with this,
guys,
bam, we're taking off
crazy
into a fully electrified future. And they're going to show us exactly how it works with this baby right here. It's rumored that this car could have up to 800 horsepower. That is so much power. Oh my God, it's going to be awesome. So the original LFA has about 550 horsepower. This right here. So 0 to 100 in just over 2 seconds. These are all of the numbers that they're kind of wanting to achieve. Obviously, we'll have to see what happens when the car actually comes out. Look, this little double bubble roof. Look at this. And this is, of course, so you can fit your helmet. So it's going to be a two-seater car. I'm joking, you don't need to wear a helmet. This car is going to be road legal, but it's cool how they have these kind of race car elements. Very, very cool. You won't have seen this car on any channel on YouTube so far. This kind of in-depth, up-close look at all of its features. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. This is what we do best on Supercar Blondie. Right. What's cool is and kind of strange is they have like this traditional-looking petrol tank.
I mean, Supercar Blondie plugs, so she's going to get all the hot shit around the world waiting for everybody else.
I suppose.
I mean, this woman being Dubai and everything. She's pretty big. The doors don't open.
I've given them feedback that when the car, you know, comes to market, we do need doors that work. We also need the car to turn. And they've taken that on board and they're like, I'm so glad you came here today. What would we do without you? I was like, that's why I'm here, guys, you know. Instead of the doors opening and it actually being able to turn, they are coming up with something super, super cool. They're considering actually putting a simulated gearbox in this. You know, that's something that a lot of people miss.
Man, that thing
you know,
is
having
crazy,
an electric
man.
Car and not being able to change
I
the
I wish
gears.
You'd stand off to the
They're
side.
Thinking, hang on a minute, how do we
instead
give
of taking
that
the
kind
camera
of
shot, I wish you stand off
to
the side so we can see the car more
car.
Instead of her.
So this is something
I would like to
rumored
see the car
that
more.
They are thinking about putting
a better
in this
angle.
Car.
See
now,
it?
I would
Y'all
love
see it
to
now?
See how they do that. Just like kind of
instead of focusing on Blondie talking, I want to see the car.
I like it. All right.
Because the car
now,
is really what's
the
up.
Interior, I think they're going to have some really cool features in there. Like when you start the car, the speedometer ring kind of moves from this position to this position.
Remember
and
the LFA did that.
And glows and stuff. It'd be so epic. And then on the original LFA, what was so cool is those really nice like indicator paddles. I want to see what they do with all of those things that we love about the original LFA and kind of elevate them in this car. Now with the seats, who knows, maybe they're going to go for racing bucket seats, something
nice.
Super lightweight, keep
nice.
The weight down so that obviously you can go further in the car. Maybe they've got some beautiful ambient lights. That's what we love. We love these little features and it just makes you feel so cool when you sit in the actual driver's seat. For now, this is your sneak peek of the LFA successor. What do you think?
Come on, man. Y'all see that shit. That shit is crazy, bro. Dope.
Lexus has just revealed an electric replacement for the legendary LFA. But that's not all, because Toyota has also revealed a brand new electric sports car that could bring back the iconic MR2 name. And if that wasn't enough, it's also revealed another 13 brand new EVs. There's a new electric pickup truck, a load of SUVs, some tasty-looking saloons, and even a bunch of vans. In this video, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about all these cars.
Buying a new car? Then head to CarWow, and my team will help you find your next car at a fair price. CarWow.
It's a lot of shit, man. But I just wanted to give y'all a sneak peek of that. I'm going to give me some chips. I'm hungry, bro. But Lexus is going crazy. If that come out, man, that's probably going to come out 2025. Guarantee it, 2025. What y'all think, man? Y'all think y'all like it? It's whack, it's trash, it's ugly. I guarantee people might, oh, it's ugly, man. Oh, man, listen. Car designs go any which way. That's what make them car design. That's what make creativity, bro. Car is beautiful. What they did the front, the taking air and all that. They went crazy. That's all I want to talk to y'all about. I'm not going to be in here long. I've been fucking busy, though. Y'all probably want to know what I've been doing. Everybody want to know what I'm doing. So, I want to show y'all something. Got my own clothes. I will let y'all know how to buy them. My clothes are in. Tires on Tarmac is on there. It's one of my 2Xs. I got plenty of sizes. I got 2Xs. I got larges. I got smalls. And I got 1Xs too. Largest. And you see? Quality. See on the neck right here? Got the brand right there too. The neck. It's not a Gildan, but this is next to Gildan. This is really high quality shirt. So my merch is in. It's like I told you, TOT got his merch in. As you see the shirt. This is a 2X I'm rocking right now. Tires on Tarmac official shirt, my X. Just a nice clean look. This is the shirts right here, guys. I will have all information where you guys can contact me. Probably gonna go through my PO. When I get my PO box, I'm gonna have it all set up. Y'all can go get y'all shirts. They're going for 25 a pop. They're very affordable, 25 a piece. And when I got my PO box set up, y'all, what y'all gonna do is you're gonna DM me on my one of my outlets, my social media outlets for the shirts and the hats and whatever I'm selling. Once you DM me, I'm gonna respond. Then when I respond, I'm gonna say send your bread to this PO box, right? When you send a money order, no checks. Just send a money order, no cash, no check. Just send a money order or a cashier's check. It's fine. Send it for $25 and send it to me. And then it'll hit my PO box. Once I receive payment and have your address also along with that payment, where to send your shirt so I can send you your shit. I want to make sure you guys get your shit. I'm not about no crazy shit, taking people money, not getting their shit. I want to make sure you get your shit. As soon as I get the bread, I'm sending your shirt, all your shirts together, boom, boom, whatever you let, wherever you let to write to you. So that's how we're going to do it. I'll let you know. I got a whole giant box of them. Don't worry about it. I'm not running out because I haven't really sold any. You know what I'm saying? And that's what it is, guys. I got my own gear. I've been doing that. I told you I was going to make that happen. I made that happen. I just been busy, man. Real busy. Busy, 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 man. I'm back in the CMVs. You don't know what a CMV is. It's commercial motor vehicles. I'm not driving trucks. I'm driving a yard dog truck. So basically, I don't go nowhere. I just stay in the yard all day. It's enough money to keep the company going. Y'all know I've been working at Amazon, doing all type of shit. I just been working, bro. I'm hungry, excuse me. I've just been working. Work, work, paying my bills, taking care of these people that I love. I mean, the merch. And TOT merch, bro. TOT merch, bro. You know what I'm saying? That's what I've been doing, grinding, boy. See that? See the tag? Even got it on the size and the company right there. My brother just invested in me. I'm happy about that. I didn't even ask him to do the shit. Matter of fact, he told me about it, and I told him, don't even do it, bro. I can't pay you back right now. I'm too caught up in this, that, and the third. Bro. I know this Negro did it anyway. So now I'm obligated more than ever to make my own shit. I'm about to start making my own clothes. I'm gonna still mess with the guy I mess with. But I mean, this is quality, bro. Y'all see the stitching? The stitching. That's quality. But let me show you what my brother got me. Y'all gonna be tripping y'all balls off and y'all vaginas off. Check this out. I don't wanna be vulgar, but it's true. So I got two mock-ups. This ain't TOT. I got two mock-ups from a white tee and a black tee to do my practice, right? So he got me this. Shout out to Verum. It's a company out of China. This is their brand. This is their brand logo. If y'all want to check them out, Verum. This is the heat transfer vinyl instructions. This is heat transfer. We got all the colors. As you see, I have all the colors right here. You can kind of see the color. I'm not breaking out the packs. We got green, purple, red. You can kind of see right in there the different colors. See them? As I flip it just a little bit, you can see them. So I got that. This is where you make the actual words and all that, whatever design or image. And it's got that. And then he got me the actual machine to apply it.
Crit Cut Easy Press 2. I ain't even open it up. This came in just like a week ago, bro. See that? Yeah, presses the image on there, bro. I'm so happy. Brand new. So I got to get a couple things before I start building my shirts. I got to get the table. I got to get the proper table so I can press on there real good. And just some gloves. Guys, I'm really happy about it, man. My company is growing, man. I'm really building this motherfucker from seed. Cherry is like $900 left on Cherry. I told y'all I had that bitch paid off, so $900 left. Boom, I had that bitch paid off, man. So remember, I'm growing. I activated my my Class A. I kept it, so I'm good on that. I'm driving my CMV. I'm not driving nowhere. I'm able to come home every night. I work like 12 plus hours a day, but fuck it. You know what I'm saying? It's grinding. You know what I mean, right? I ain't selling dope. I ain't about to go that route. I'm selling shirts, bro. You feel me, y'all? I know y'all feeling that shit. I ain't selling no fucking dope. I'm selling shirts, bro. Shirts, hats. TOT's gonna be getting to shoes. I like my designer socks, hats, all that. Man, we gonna be selling all that shit. We gonna be selling female shit too. I'm going crazy. But this is the start. The shirts are a start. As you see, I got mine on right now. I got Tires on Tarmac shirt. You will see me at certain car shows and videos that I upload with my shit on. The hats will be in soon. You're going to like the hats. I'm doing other colors. As y'all like the clean look, I'm going to start going ahead and start showing you my mind with my more elaborate designs. Right now, I'm going clean and like a clean corporate look. This is something you can rock at the barbecue. They'd be like, Tires on Tarmac, what's that? And you'd be like, oh, this is my dude. This is my man. I fuck with this YouTuber. This is shit. You know what I'm saying? It's all, you know, it's clean. You can rock this with your ones. You can rock this with your J's. You know what I'm saying? It ain't no crazy, too elaborate color scheme type. You can just type. Boom, you know what I'm saying? Clean, and it feel good, nice and cottony. You know what I'm saying? Fuck with the campaign. I'm going to let y'all know when I get my P.O. box open how to go ahead, hit me up on IG and refer, and that's how we're going to do it. So when you hit me up on IG or Snap, you give me all your information where you want me to send it to. You send your bread to my P.O. box. When I get my P.O. box, I'm going to send it in the link in the description below, guys. No capping, as the young people say. And it's going to be there for you to know where to send it to the proper P.O. box to get to me, to my company, and so I can send you your shit right away. And I don't take long sending shit. I jump right on it. So, yeah, man, that's what's been going on, grinding, man. I've been paying my bills, catching up shit, still building myself back from when I got sick a few years ago. Things is not like heaven on earth, but I can't complain, you know what I mean? I'm feeling good, man. I'm back running. I'm running now. As far as my fitness, man, I'm back out there running, man. Feeling good, man. Feeling real good. I damn near don't have a stomach no more. And what else? Car almost paid off. I'm about to order the rims for Cherry. About to go ahead and order some maintenance parts for Cherry. It's got to get it. You know, I got to get the oil change again, too, for this fall. But I'm about to order the lower half. So some of the things I'm going to order maintenance-wise, we're going to order the whole lower half getting ordered. I got that saved in my cart already. Some two ball joints for Betsy, because Betsy about to get traded in. Because I'm about to upgrade my wife first. We're about to get her either a Toyota RAV4 or the BMW X1. So either one, I'm going to get her fully equipped, whatever. So get her the fuck out the way, because we're about to go ahead and get the LT1. That's what we on. We need to get the LT1, get a fucking... We're trying to get that damn allocation, get the LT1 with that C8 engine in it, that 455 horsepower LT1. That's what we are. And I want an orange one, either orange one or all white one. That, and then, yeah, Cherry Rams is coming. We're going to put the chip in there. All this is going to happen this year. So the car's almost paid off, so I'm going to go crazy with finishing up. It's almost done. Sound's going to get put in there. We're going to basic setup, but it's still going to be knocking. And I'm going to upgrade this alarm on it, because Cherry is pretty much based mine. That's the campaign car to market the car. The LT1 is the Gooch. Y'all already know that's the Gooch. That's the name of it. That's a boy. Cherry is a girl. The name of her is a girl. Not a girl car, but it's a girl name on that car, Cherry. But the LT1, the Camaro, that's a boy name. It's called the Gooch. So anyway, I'm getting the license plate on there. It's going to say the Gooch on there and everything. And the vanity plate. But anyway, shit, man. That's about all I have, man. It's definitely a pleasure always rocking out with y'all. I ain't forgot y'all, man. Don't ever think if it's 2 weeks, 3 weeks, don't give a fuck. Don't ever think that I didn't shut things down or anything. Don't ever think that, man. I'm just hella busy. You know, it's a lot because real quick, and it's all fairness, I'm a man with a family and the whole shebang. I'm doing regular everyday shit like the next man who got a family, a house and all that, blah, 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 right? But I'm starting a startup company, so you got to understand that's not easy. That's not easy, my man. That's not easy, sis. You know what I'm saying? So what I'm doing is a lot behind the scenes. You know how long it took me to even get to this point where I can sit there and say, man, I got my own shirts. You know what I'm saying? Now I got my own shirts. I manifested. I talked. I'm holding up my own shit. So, you know, it just takes time, man. You know what I mean? I'm proud of myself, man. I'm proud of myself, man. This is me. This is me, bro. My design, my everything, bro. This, I'm proud of myself. You know what I'm saying? I mean, just proud of myself, bro. I manifested. I said I'd do so. I followed through and I made it happen, man. That's what it's about. Not giving up and everything you say you're going to do, do it, follow through with it. Complete what you start. You start something, complete it. So, man, other than that, guys, man, I'm happy. I just wanted to check in with y'all, tap in. I hope you like that new talk about the new electric EV supercar LFA. They don't even have a name for it. I hope it don't come out with no dumbass name like LFAB, LFA prototype. That's, you know, come up with a clever name, Japan. Don't be, hey, maybe y'all need to talk to me. I'm good with names. Anyway, guys, man, y'all stay sucker free out there, man. I'm going to check out y'all real soon. We're going to start back since I'm back in the CMVs and in my groove. Because I had to get back into my groove. You know, this truck shit, you know, you got to reacclimate. But, you know, I don't go nowhere. I'm just working in the yard. Like I say, I'm a yard dog. So I don't truck. I just stay in the yard and work and do back end 53-foot trailers all day. And that's all I do. So I'm happy about that. The money's good, but I work a lot. But I'm definitely acclimating my schedule where I can do this live back what I was every week consistently. And that's going to be happening, man. You know what I'm saying? And thank y'all for support, man. Thank y'all for fucking with the campaign and fucking with me building this startup, man. And like I say, man, I'll be rocking out with y'all soon. I will be giving y'all the plug when I get my PO so y'all can go ahead and contact me. And then just keep up on my lives, man, so you'll know when my PO box is really up and running. And then just hit me up, DM me on my IG, tires_on_tarmac. DM me on that. You can DM me on Snap, you know what I'm saying, Facebook. And then give me your information where you want me to send your shit, your shirt. And then I'll send it to you. You know what I'm saying? Like that. If I run out of 2Xs, I'll let you know. If I just have large, I'll let you know because a lot of people wear 2X. 3Xs I've already sold on the street that people that I know, that I don't have to reach out to them on the PO. I know them, so I sold a couple. My 3X is already gone. I'm selling shit out the trunk, too. I got ships in the trunk, too. So I just wanted to let y'all know, man, they're $25. There will be $25 a piece, all sizes, very affordable. Shit, y'all spend more on y'all weed and drink. But anyway, much love. Hope you enjoyed the live, man. Rock out with y'all soon. Stay sucker free. Stay away from people. Stay low, man. And just stay away from people that's going to keep and stunt your growth, man. And whatever you do, man. I'll talk to y'all soon. Much love, y'all. All right, my riders. Till next time.